Welcome to the Corp Vault channel. In our previous videos, we discussed Comcell users and roles. In this video, we will discuss Comcell user groups. Please like, share, comment or suggest. Subscribe for more videos. And you can follow us on Instagram. In the Comcell browser, expand security and click on Comcell user groups. User groups are a collection of users that make it easy to control a large number of users. User groups provide a convenient means of assigning a common set of permissions, also called capabilities, and resources to a set of users. Properties and security associations selected for the user group apply to all of the users in the group. You can create any number of user groups, each having any combination of assigned permissions. Comcell user groups are associated with Comcell entities, for example, clients, libraries, storage policies, etc., enabling the member user to perform authorized tasks on those entities only. A Comcell user can be a member of any number of Comcell user groups. The user's ability to perform tasks on a Comcell entity is determined by the combined capabilities of the Comcell user groups that are associated with that entity. Proper user group administration requires a certain amount of planning. Successful planning helps you minimize the number of groups, which is always desirable from an administrative standpoint. When planning your user group strategy, you need to think: who needs access to ComVault? What tasks the user, he or she, need to perform? As an administrator, what are your security needs? Taking all these into account, you need to decide their roles, the permissions to be given, and those need to be assigned to the user group. Two default user groups are automatically created when the software is installed. These are Master Group, which have all capabilities for all associations, and the View All Group, whose members have all association level access in the Comcell console for viewing privileges only. You cannot delete these user groups. Users who are not members of the View All group can only see those objects, jobs, and events to which their Comcell user groups have been associated. As you see, we have only one user group master, which was created during install. The View All group is not created for some reason. We will try to create the group in some time. Let's discuss a bit about Master Group. The administrator that is created during the installation of the software is automatically a member of the Master User Group. You can use the administrator account to set up the Comcell environment and perform initial configuration. The administrator has full permissions in the Comcell environment and can access all entities in the environment. You can use the administrator account to create users and add users to the master user group. The users added to the group will have the same permissions as the administrator. Let's try create the View All group now. Right-click on Comcell user group. Select new user group. Name is the name of the user group. We are trying to create View All user group. In the description, type some descriptive information about the user group. For example, a general description about the user group. Enabled is selected by default, which means the user group is enabled. If the option is unchecked or cleared, the user group is disabled, and the associations and the Comcell resources for this group are unavailable to the members of the user group. Enforce file system quota. Use this option to limit file system backups for clients that are owned by this external user by the quota that you specify in the next field. Disable data protection when quota usage exceeds. Enter the limit of quota usage to disable the data protection. Enforce edge drive quota. Use this option to limit amount of space that a user can use on their edge drive repository. Disable upload of new data when edge drive quota exceeds. Enter the limit of space to disable the upload of any new data. Age password in end days. Enabling this option allows you to set the number of days for which the password is to remain valid. At the end of this period, the users who are part of the group are prompted to enter a new password for their account. Members tab. Use this window to add or remove the member users to or from the user group. Available members lists the user accounts that are not assigned to the user group. Associated members lists the user accounts that are assigned to the user group. Create new user. Use this option to create a new user. This user can then be associated to the user group. Associated entities tab. Each ComCell user group must be assigned permissions and objects so that its member users can perform functions within the ComCell. A ComCell user group can be assigned all permissions and/or all associations or individual associations and permissions. Please note, all of the security associations that affect the user group are listed here. The security associations applied to the user group are applied to all the users who are associated with the user group. Click Add to add an association. Add association window. Use this window to add entities and roles to users and user groups. The user group, the role, and the entities create the three-way security association. Entities. Displays the names of the entities, in other words, ComCell objects, that can be associated with this user group. ComCell objects are levels in the ComCell that a user group can be associated with. ComCell object associations enable members of a group to perform operations on a specific object. The nature of those operations depends on the permissions assigned to the group. If an object, such as a client computer group or higher level object, is not associated with a given ComCell user group, then the users of that group cannot perform any operations involving that client computer. The following objects can be associated with a ComCell user group. Each of these objects supports specific functions within the ComCell. You can browse through each entity and select the desired ones. If you are not sure of the location of entity, then use the Find box to look for the entity. Let's select all entities for this view all group. Please select role that can be associated with this user group. If none of the roles have the permissions you need, you can create a role by clicking Create Role, or you can add permissions without creating a role by clicking Custom Role. Select View Role for this user group. Once done, click OK. We will end this video here. In our next video, we will continue discussing other options. Please hit the like button if you like this video and subscribe to our channel if not already done so. Thank you. Do subscribe for more videos.